The campaign got a little funnier this week. President Obama stopped by The Daily Show on the same day that both candidates did routines at the Al Smith dinner in New York.
When suddenly I pulled ahead in some of the major polls, what was the headline? Polls show Obama leading from behind.
I particularly want to apologize to Chris Matthews. 4 years ago, I gave him a thrill up his leg. This time around, I gave him a stroke.
How many times a week does Biden show up in a wet bathing suit to a meeting? Just ballpark figure.
I had to put out a presidential directive on that. We had to stop that.
You got to put towels down.
I got to say, though, he looks pretty good.
No.
Now, to be fair, Jackie Kucinich, John Stewart asked Obama a bunch of serious questions as well.
Right, but and that was the news that came out of that.
President isn't exactly going on the Sunday shows. How important now is going on The Daily Show?
You go on The Daily Show when you want to reach a certain demographic of people, and Obama needs the youth vote to come out. So I think, I mean, for that purpose, it is important. But, you know, for our purposes, I think they're catering to us at this point. So,
well, they're not catering to us.
And if you need youth to come out, you're going to go on The Daily Show, and they need that.
Nia-Malika Henderson, Romney, of course, has not been on The Daily Show. And this week he canceled on The View. He said he was going to go on. Instead, he sent Ann. How can he possibly be elected president if he can't do these shows?
Well, I actually think this is a bad move on Mitt Romney's part. I think people get their news in different ways. The View, Saturday Night Live, if you remember, in 2008, Hillary Clinton, John McCain, Sarah Palin, and Barack Obama all went on Saturday Night Live because they know that those venues fuel the dialogue and fuel the sort of a water cooler chit-chat that goes on around the office. So I actually think it's a real misreading of the intersection of pop culture and politics, which I think Barack Obama has read very well, and that's why you see him on shows like The View and also picking up on this Big Bird meme.
Obviously, they want to show a lighter side of their personalities, Roger, but 2.5 weeks before the election, why would both of them go to the Al Smith dinner? Does the press scoff at candidates who can't do comedy?
Well, who can't deliver lines written by comedy writers.
I was setting you up.
They were both hilarious. The Al Smith dinner is a tradition. It's sponsored by the Catholic Archdiocese of New York. Catholic voters are extremely important swing voters in America. You're not going to tick off the Archdiocese.
Don't diss the dinner.
So you put on your white tie, you show up. And both ended on very nice notes of humility, whether sincere or not. About liking each other and how important it was.
So while journalists, just to wrap this up, while journalists might prefer that these guys constantly come on CNN, the other cable networks, and do network interviews and all of that, it seems like the center of gravity of the media have moved to The View and The Daily Show.
Oh, sure.
And Leno and Letterman.
We're a celebrity-driven culture. We're a personality-driven culture. We want to see them be human beings, away from that lectern and away from that stump speech that we're all sick of. And I think, this is personally my own personal analysis, Romney's declining to do it is a sign of falling on the ball. He thinks he has this election won. He's not going to do risky things like going on The View or going on Jon Stewart.
Funny that that's now risky. Roger Simon, Jackie Kucinich, Nia-Malika Henderson down in Boca Raton.